Oh, what is up, you guys? It's the Sandman back at it again, and we're wrapping up this concert from Live at the Rainbow by the one and only Queen. Looks like this is kind of the covers that they're playing now. Big Spender, I think Modern Times Rock and Roll is actually an original song by them, if I'm not mistaken. But Big Spender, I know Jailhouse Rock's coming up after this. So, yeah, man, let's see what they got. I'm expecting a very energetic, upbeat type of finish after that performance of In the Lap of the Gods, the revisited version. So, you know, let's see what they do to wrap up the show, man. Let's go. Attitude he brings to this song, man. I love the lower voice and the gravelly sound that he has. Really cool stuff. Could potentially be very good in heavier metal-esque genres if he utilizes that voice. I'm looking forward to coming across a song where he uses that vocal technique, that vocal style. That's really cool. And I love how he hits "Hey Big Spender." Those high notes are very again, really great stuff. Nice call and response with the guitars as well. Solid. Yeah, cymbals. Before the solo, man, this sounds a lot like Bread Fan. Bread Fan by Bougie or some. I know Metallica's got a famous cover of that song on the deluxe edition of And Justice for All. And they also have a nice live version on YouTube. Bread Fan, very similar riff, man. Hammer-on from the D the 5th fret to 7th fret on the A string, and then descending back down the E string to the G note, and then back up to the, descending down to the G in that scale, E minor scale, and then back up to that main riff, part of the riff. It's a really cool riff, man, because you can utilize that open E string and the octave above. A lot of fun to use riffs like that, because then you can just use double stops on top of that, like the frets right below it. Nice pull-off licks you can make riffs out of if you base it around that. It's a really cool riff, man. Very upbeat. This is like a faster song, man. This is where you see like songs like Stone Cold Crazy, songs like this. Really cool. Well, not really cool. Well, they are really cool, but I meant to say like could possibly be big influences for future bands, faster bands, to take inspiration from them. Bands that play with a lot more speed. So let's go. Love the back and forth. Oh, go off then. Woo! I gotta hear that lick again. That was a really sick lick. Nice, man. Not White Queen. Yeah. Really cool couple songs there. I love the cover, man. I love the vocals in that cover the most. Of Big Spender. On this song, let's see what this is about, because I got the lyrics conveniently up right here. It's pretty much... sounds like just like the entrance of a new era of rock music, and it's kind of like a hype song for that, so that's pretty much all there is to it for me. Yeah, kind of referring to the old age, the old like era, 1958, that was great, whatever, knock a hole in the wall. Yep. When I was looking up, this forum, whatever, someone mentioned references to songs like Roll Over Beethoven by Chuck Berry, which is a fantastic song. And yeah, kind of the same thing. Roll Over Beethoven, there's something else is coming to town, you know, about to hit the earwaves or hit the eardrums of the new age, you know what I mean? Something new is in the making, and same thing here. Really cool stuff. I wanna go back to that first solo, so like that. Part, I think it's right here. Let's go. Nope. Nope. love how he does that over the chord change. Yep, shortened to the point, man. Shortened to the point. Let's go over that riff real quick. These two songs, a lot of just back and forth riffs, two chord patterns. Chord, whole step down, whole step back up, whole step down, whole step back up. Hear a lot of that. I think it's kind of just simplicity of the songs. You know, it's pretty good, you know, easy just to wrap up a concert with that instrumentally. But it makes it sound like, you know, a lot of fun. Great groove in the drums. I like that little solo that Roger Taylor was able to do. That was a nice little addition there, letting everyone get involved. The bass is loud and clear as ever, which is nice. It's aided, you know, he gets to shine a little more with the guitars having this ringing effect, not kind of overtaking the every part of the whole song. So that's nice. You get a lot of bass in this as well. And look at that. I just want to touch on the chord changes and the vocal changes right here. Do the main riff. The things there. Look at that. Yeah, I love how he sustains those notes in that verse. The ooh sound, when he does that. Really great vocal control, especially over, like, it can seem uncomfortable to try to sing over just an ascending pattern like that. It's kind of, like, uncomfortable. You're, like, kind of, especially if you're, like, a singer like him, you want to sing a rich, full tone. You know, with all these changes going on, you have to be, especially this late in the concert, too. Remember, this guy's technique is impeccable because he's probably worn out from a lot of, a lot of singers were probably worn out from this long of a concert thus far. You know, all these songs beforehand, he still got this control. Really nice. Really cool to see that. You know, people always seem to forget, you know, as you go on in a concert, you get tired, especially guitar players, especially playing faster type of music. Singers, definitely singers. So always keep that in mind, guys, when, especially as the concert goes on and on. The latter part of the concert, that's when a lot of performers might break, but this guy definitely doesn't, because he's Freddie Mercury, obviously. So that ascending. Yeah, that's the part I wanted. Yeah, I mean, that's it. That's all I'm going to do in the revisiting the video. Really great songs to close out this concert, man. Yeah, and they're still building tension, man. They're still going for the more challenging songs to perform. It's deceptively challenging by the looks of it, especially vocally. Especially when you're, you know, that ascending pattern just is a very cool, it sounds a little bit of, what's that word? Descent, dissonance. There's still a dissonant kind of sound that he has to wrangle with, and it's especially building up to the chorus right before the end of the verse, before the chorus. So yeah, and also sense kind of similarities to Rock and Roll by Led Zeppelin a little bit, mainly because the theme of the song, and it's kind of that ringing. There's a lot of ringing in the instrumentation. That's just me. Maybe I'm going crazy, but. Yeah, obviously very different instruments, but the same kind of vibe. that I'm getting. That's more of a bluesy number, and this is kind of, I don't even know what to call this, but yeah. So here we go, Big Spender, Modern Times Rock and Roll, man. Concert's wrapping up. I guess Jailhouse Rock and then God Save the Queen at the end. So that's it. It's the Sandman checking out. Peace.